All right, we're here at my VermiHut indoor worm bin, but first let's look at our raw versus frozen experiment. Raw was on the left and frozen was on the right. So that was about 9 days of time lapse, but let's see what's happened over 16 total days. And whoa, all that's left of tomato and cucumber is skins, and we still have some lettuce on the raw side. So let's go back over that time lapse real quick and talk about what we saw. So the mites were the star of the show on day 1 and 2, but the mold was in full force on day 3. And starting on day 4, the frozen apple and lettuce were completely gone or buried, and the cucumber was absolutely annihilated on the frozen side. Also, worms were totally covering the frozen banana. By day 5, the fresh watermelon this time was covered, and the frozen watermelon looked like a donut. And the only thing left of the frozen cucumber and tomato were the skins. We also saw the first traction of the fresh cucumber on day 5. And by day 6 through 9, the fresh apple and lettuce were taking their sweet time. So let's go ahead and dig in and see if there's any watermelon left on this fresh side or on the frozen side. So as I dig in, it looked like the watermelon that was fresh was kind of getting the first action of the worms. And I am not seeing even any skin right here. So they have totally taken care of it. Now, those two slices of watermelon came from different ends of the watermelon. So on the fresh side was kind of the tail end that had the flower end on it and really had more of the juicy stuff available to it. But let's go over here to the frozen side and see if there's any watermelon left there. And I am seeing nothing. And this side was the one that was on the stem end. Actually, I guess here is a little bit of skin of watermelon. This side was on the stem end. It had a little bit less fresh pink flesh to it. So I don't know if that is why it took a little bit longer, or, you know, this was just more juicy compared to the frozen side. Let's kind of go over here to the apples. The frozen apple kind of went first, and or it got buried. So let's just kind of look, and I'm not seeing anything from it. I think this is just a banana stem that was just an artifact from maybe earlier feedings, but no apple whatsoever there. And let's see the chewed apple. Thanks, Jason. The chewed or fresh apple right here, and it seems to be gone after 16 days, but wow, did it take a long time. And the worms kind of did their thing and then they came to it later. So it's almost like they knew they had to wait. And then over here is some lettuce. Now this lettuce went in fresh, and check it out. It is still growing. That looks like a little piece of fresh lettuce right there trying to grow. This stalk right here actually started to grow, I think on day 3 or 4, we saw it, but because the camera was overhead, you couldn't see it real well. So I would say stuff like fresh lettuce, cabbage, something like that, maybe even cauliflower. If you put it in fresh and it's still alive, then it may keep growing. The worms are not going to eat something that is alive like this. So let's come over here and look and see if there was anything left of this lettuce over here on the frozen side. And I'm not feeling anything at all. So yeah, totally annihilated it. So fresh versus frozen lettuce, absolutely freeze your lettuce. I would say same thing with the apples. The watermelon, I don't know. I don't know if that was because I had different kind of pieces or if the fresh watermelon was kind of a go. Now let's look over here at the cucumber, and right here, this cucumber, look at that. We still have some skin left to it, and I don't really see any flesh. Actually there is a little bit of flesh of the cucumber left right there, but over here I'm not expecting to see much. I think just the same thing, just the skin. So certainly on something like this, they, you know, just kind of hollow out and leave the skin, and this will take a little bit longer for them to eat. Now I think we had 2 tiny tomatoes. Here's the frozen side. It's just the skin. And I think over here also just the skin, and then maybe some tomato seedlings right here. I don't know, but they are certainly growing there. Now the banana, when we looked at that time lapse, it looked like the worms went right for the frozen banana first and ate kind of all the fleshy stuff off it and left the skin of the banana. And then they went over to this one and it kind of melted into the watermelon. So let me see if there's any of the skin part left, but I'm not seeing any of them. But what I do think happened is they kind of stripped the flesh off and then then got to the peel itself. So very interesting. This was a really cool experiment. I think that we have discovered that frozen is clearly the winner. You want to freeze your food. It helps the worms to break it down faster and the microbes, and they will turn it into castings faster. Over here, we kind of, you know, word out on melon. Maybe putting your watermelon and cantaloupes right into your bin is no problem. You really don't need to freeze them. But some of this other stuff like the cucumbers, tomatoes, certainly lettuce, definitely want to freeze that. And even the apple, I would freeze. And same thing with the banana peel. So pretty interesting results. Let's go ahead and dig in here some more. And we are actually going to do a rotation. Now, I have several videos that show you how I rotate. And what I've done with this one is I've just taken the harvest tray out from underneath this. I've actually put it in my urban worm bag because I'm going to use all those worms that are in there and let them go into my urban worm bag. One time I did count the number of worms that were in my pre-harvest tray. I think it was 809. So the urban worm bag is going to get about another 1,000 worms in it. And then after we kind of dig around here, I'm going to go ahead and put my old inoculating tray on top, and that's going to become the new top feeding tray, and we're going to go ahead and feed this. So let's just kind of dig around in here a little bit. Oh, this looks like the pineapple bottom that has been in here and we've been checking on. They've almost taken care of it completely. Lots of worms. Check out all the worms. They are into the mango seed. Oh, you know what? Last video, I think we saw just one or two worms in the mango seed, and we saw kind of a big cotyledon. So let's open this up and see what they are doing now. And oh man, sure enough, look at that. They are all inside that seed. That is really cool. This has a lot of nutrition in it, obviously because it's a seed, so the worms are definitely seeking it out after it's kind of degraded a little bit. And even with, oh my gosh, check that out. Oh my gosh, they are way inside there. I was going to kind of pull this open and look at it, and wow, just like a worm ball inside the mango seed. Check that out. Check out all those worms. Let me see if I can try and put this back together, and we're just going to leave this in here for them. Let's keep digging around. All right, so a couple of observations. This is some really good castings in here. So it actually has another 60 days or so that it is going to be the pre-harvest tray, and they will eat all the rest of this bedding that's in here and some of these food scraps. But some of this stuff that's taking a really long time, I'm gonna put it into the new top feeding tray. So what we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna take the oldest inoculating tray and I'm gonna put it on top as the new top feeding tray. And this is gonna be the second one down to be the pre-harvest tray. All right, here we are at the new top feeding tray. It used to be the old inoculating tray. And one of the things I wanna show you is look at all the worms on the top. And that is because we just spent all that time kind of digging around in that tray above it and the worms came down. So in our urban worm bag right now is that pre-harvest tray that I am just gonna be digging around, and you can see the worms want to go down as you agitate. It's a great method for harvesting your VermiHut is to agitate and let the worms go down. So let's go ahead and fluff this up, and then we're gonna set a feeding inside here. Yeah, as you can see, this thing has some castings in it and it is super moist. Now we put totally dry shredded cardboard in here, and over time, this is what happens to it. This is probably somewhere around 120 days of just sitting down here and absorbing all the drippings from any of the food scraps that we have here. And I like to do this because what it does is it prevents water from kind of sitting down in that basin, and it keeps everything really clean for me. At any time, I usually have about two inoculating trays that are on here just full of dry cardboard. It is amazing to me just how many worms I'm seeing down here. This is incredible. And the volume is still pretty good after I fluffed it up. So I'm really happy with the moisture level and everything. This thing is ready to go. It is absolutely primed and inoculated with all kinds of microbes. Clearly, the worms love it, so it is ready to get fed. With every feeding, it's important to put new bedding in, so that's what I'm doing right here. And I just take cardboard boxes and I shred them in my 12-sheet cross-cut micro shredder, and it produces some fabulous cardboard shreds. Look how tiny that is. I have links in the description for all the equipment that I use if you want to see prices or that kind of thing or what I use. Amazon affiliate links there for you. So next thing we're going to do is we're just going to lay down all the old food that we had. And this right here, we'll see if it keeps growing or if it kind of dies out and the worms get to it. So now we're ready for our feeding, and this is what I had in mind. This is just some frozen food scraps that we put in our freezer to collect them as we go throughout the week. And then we're just gonna load it in here, and this is gonna attract the rest of the worms up into this top feeding tray. So we've got a half a banana here, and I'm just gonna kind of open it up for them so they can get to it easier. Then we've got some broccoli, and we've got some pineapple. Then let's see what else we got. We've got some tomatoes right there. We've got, looks like a cauliflower stalk, and then some of their favorite, which is some watermelon. Clearly we saw they like to go to that first, so I'm just gonna kind of spread it around here. And then, yep, some tomatoes over there. Let's add some watermelon to them right there. And then I'll add in just a little piece of onion. Yes, you can put onion in your worm bin in moderation. And then this, a frozen lettuce. So this will be interesting. Is this lettuce gonna go before that other lettuce that we had down there? And then just a little bit more stuff. So we've got a lot of fast food that will attract them and some slow food like that banana. So this should be a good feeding for them. And I hope to be in here in about 10 days. So I think this will attract them. Let's go ahead and add our amendments. So first thing we're gonna do is put in some worm chow. And this is just some stuff that I have in my pantry that it's expired, mostly grains and sugars, that kind of thing. And it's just another food source for them, and I'll put that all around. Then I like to dispose of my coffee grounds in my worm bins also. And again, a good source of nitrogen and other nutrients for the worms and eventually for my garden. Then the final amendment I like to use is just some pulverized eggshells. And again, another chance for me to avoid the landfill and put things like nutrients into my garden. And certainly I think eggshells have a lot of calcium, and the worms can use it for grit to help make their food smaller as they eat it. Next, I'm just gonna add a little bit more bedding on top, and I'm gonna go ahead and bury this up. And while I'm doing that, in appreciation for staying this long, I'm gonna string together some more of those time lapses together so you can look at different sections of them as they're going. And then I'll see you on the other side. Pretty cool, huh? I have managed to bury this, and there's a little bit of a mound right here, but that's okay. It will decrease as the worms eat everything. And then let's go ahead and finish this off with a little piece of newspaper on top, and we'll see how long it takes them to also eat this up. So I hope you've enjoyed this raw versus frozen experiment. I know I did, and I hope you enjoyed those time lapses. So I hope you're having a great day. I hope your worm bins are doing fantastic. So happy vermicomposting, everybody. Take care now.